So, good morning, everybody. Myself, Dr. Thipperudraswamy. I have written book on personality development system. So today I'm here to discuss mainly about the false positive results in the diagnosis of coronavirus disease. There can be false positive results and false negative results. Please remember, the person who is a medical professional, who is a doctor, can understand it better, and your community medicine people and microbiologists can understand this situation correctly. Of course, medicine people and all. So it's a very simple false positive and false negative. Every medical student will be taught about this false positive and false negative results. Very simple. See, in the false negative results, false negative means the patient has the disease, but when you are doing the test comes as negative. False negative. The patient has the disease, but the test comes as negative. So remember three major reasons. I remember it as HQT. Q stands for quality of the specimen. Quality of the specimen. In case of deep lower respiratory tract infections, you are not able to get the deep samples like alveolar brushings, alveolar bronchial brushings, bronchoalveolar lavage and all. Okay. And you are not getting sufficient sample. Okay. That is the one of the drawback. And quality of the sample, whenever you discuss about the quality of the sample, all medical professional knows that we know about quality of the sputum for tuberculosis, what we are testing. So likewise, there is a quality for this also. So the sputum quality is also required. And again, sometimes they just give the saliva and all. Okay, we all know about. So you should remember the quality of the sample also matters in the diagnosis of coronavirus disease. Okay. Yeah, that is regarding your false negative results. Okay. And second is, in the second reason is HQT stands for time. Time of collection of the sample. That means when you are collecting the sample too early, or when you are collecting the sample very late. After 2 weeks if you are collecting, after 3 weeks if you are collecting, then the amount of isolation and amount of getting the percentage of getting the test positive will be less. That is, we say it as acute and convalescent stage. It will be difficult to, comparatively, it will be difficult to get the positive results. And also, the thing is, we think about carriers. Here, there is a chances of these young, immunocompetent people becoming the healthy carriers of this virus. So, please remember, they can be carriers. They have the capability, even though they don't have the disease, even though they don't have the symptoms, even though their tests are positive, but they have the capability, they have the ability to spread the disease. We declare it as a carriers, healthy carriers, what we call that. There is a chance of healthy coronavirus carriers who can spread the disease. That's why we require quarantine and isolation. So that also you have to remember. And these are the false negative. Okay, the reason for false negative, I repeat, one is the quality of the sample. And the second one is time of collection. Whenever you are too early sample or too late sample collection. And also healthy carriers who don't have the disease, who test negative. We call it as latent disease or latent patients who have the disease, but they are not able to demonstrate any symptoms. They are not able to get any test positive by either serology or any other antigen detection test or PCR test. Okay, so they are called as latent disease, and those patients will be test negative, but they will be the healthy carriers. And second important thing which you have to remember here is your false positive results. Remember, this will be usually seen, but I think antibody detection, coronavirus antibody detection tests are, I think they are not taking into consideration for confirmation, but still I say that, see, confirmation only with the antibody detection test like ELISA. For the coronavirus antibody detection by ELISA, if they are positive, single positive antibody test for corona cannot be declared as positive, because there should be a fourfold rise in the titre of antibodies and paired sera to be taken. That means if you are doing the test now, if the test is positive for antibodies today, you have to take the sample of 2 weeks. That is called as paired sera, and you have to get the fourfold rise in the titre of antibodies. Then only you can declare this corona patient as positive corona patient with only antibody detection test. But in combination with antigen detection test, you can declare it as positive. Say for example, antigen detection test is your ELISA. ELISA antigen detection test plus micro neutralization test for the neutralizing antibodies of coronavirus. That can be taken in combination, okay? That can be done. That is followed in some of the countries. But remember, antibody detection test alone cannot give the positive, single positive test cannot be taken as positive. But only only antibody detection test is available. At that time, you use paired sera and you have to look for the rise in the titer of antibodies of more than fourfold rise in the titer of antibodies is essential. Okay, that is very important. And second thing which you have to remember here is, you know, the antigen detection test, antibody detection test, and PCR we have discussed. Okay, the false positive, single antibody detection test positive, if taken as positive, is a false positive result. Okay, paired sera, fourfold rise in titer of antibodies is essential with a single antibody detection, with antibody detection test. Only antibody detection test is available. At that time, you take a paired sera and look for the fourfold rise in the titer of antibodies. Okay. And in the antigen detection test, you can do it. You can declare it as positive. And the targets I have told you. And antigen detection test along with micro neutralization assay, searching for the neutralizing antibodies, believe me, neutralizing antibodies, if they are present in the patient, that shows the immunity of the patient. Okay, so that's why you have to remember about searching for this amount of neutralizing antibodies. When you do for HIV and all, we see more than 50% of neutralizing antibodies are there or not, like that. So that is very important. So searching for the neutralizing antibodies is also an essential criteria in the diagnosis of the coronavirus disease and prognosis. And when you think about the prognosis of coronavirus disease, that neutralizing antibodies are also essential, searching or detection. Okay, so two things are important. And one more thing I'm telling, so one should have a healthy respect for the fear of corona, because I'll tell you one story. Because there is one in forest, there was one tiger, and everyone was telling that there is a tiger in the forest, don't go. Okay, and people are afraid of going to the forest, and the tiger was there, and no one went to the entered the forest. In the meanwhile, one person came and he told, they are telling tiger is there in the forest, but they have seen the tiger 1 month back. No, I don't know, it might have died or it might have escaped from this forest. So I will take the risk and I will go to the forest. Okay, so he will enter the forest, but the tiger will be alive and it will attack him and it kills him. So that person who took the risk and went to the forest, even though people told that there was a tiger in the forest, is not having any fear. Healthy respect for the fear, so he's lost his life. Similarly, this coronavirus fear we should have, such that we should follow all government rules and whatever the instruction given by the district administration, state administration, and the national administration, and we should follow it, okay? Or else we lose our life, okay? So thank you. Myself, Dr. Thipperudraswamy, I have written book on personality development system, and thank you. Jai Ganesh, Jai Shri Ram, Jai Shankar. Thank you.